good morning, ladies. We're gonna paint the pumpkin truck today. Let me bring that down just a little bit so you can see the truck better. With our pumpkins in it that we're going to be painting today. Let's see if I can get my computer up so I can see any comments that may be coming in. There we are. Okay, got that going. All right, so let's start this morning off with painting the truck part. I think we want to do that in a teal color, but I don't have that out right now. Let's get our teal out. Here we go. Excuse me. Let's see if I can open that. There we go. Thought I was going to have to pick a different color. Ooh. A bunch of coagulated paint stuck to the lid. Today's been the morning of technical difficulties, which is why I'm running a little bit late today. So I'm not surprised that within the first 2 minutes, I got paint all over me. I'm just going to paint all of what would be the outside of the truck in this tealy color. So when you guys come on and watch this morning, just say hi. I like it when people say hi. And let us know where you're watching from. Is Jace's first day in middle school, first day in a new school, so it's pretty exciting. So I'm just painting the background of the truck color right now. Just laying in that base color. And I'm not too worried about going over any of the lines I have drawn because I have my template that I can always go back and put those back in if I can't see them through this. And I'm just making sure everything's fully covered now. I've got all of it laid in, but I just want to make sure that I didn't miss any pieces and that it's nice and solid. I might want to add a little rust to this truck too. Give it a little patina. So once I go over and make sure I got everything nice and solid, I think I'm going to get out that metallic-y, copperish looking color that I like so much. If you come on and you're watching this morning, just say hi. I like it when people say hi. And just say where you're watching from What you doing this morning? This is that metallic color I like so much. It's called Champagne Gold. I don't know if you can see that in the camera. It is made by Deco Art as well. Well, I might not be using it because I might not be able to get it open. We'll see how this works. There we go. Perfect. Just give it a tiny little touch of like a patina, rusty feel. Okay, that's it, just a tiny bit. Go ahead and do some black on these tires. Just a touch, shouldn't take much. And then we'll add some white to it and make the gray for the bumper. Just to make sure I got it nice and covered and it's nice and solid, I'm just putting a second coat on it. Alright, now I'm going to add a little white to that black and we're going to make a gray for the bumper. we got that gray in there for the bumper. We're going to mix up a little blue to do this back windshield color. But you didn't think I had any blue on my table, so hang on 1 second. Work perfect. Don't even have to mix anything. Excuse me. So this is Bahama Blue. And I'm going to do the windshield and the reflections in the little mirrors with this blue. To get my brush nice and cleaned out because I had that black in there and I don't want that in my light blue. And I'm going to do more mirrors here. I'm going to need a different brush to do the edges, so I'm just going to get the big stuff done right this second. And then I'm going to get a smaller, flatter brush to do all the edges so I don't go over any lines that I don't intend to. Turn this the other way. Hand works better going in that direction. My finger went into the gray and smeared it a little bit. Let's see if we can save it with a baby wipe here. And it took a little bit of the teal off too, but that's okay because we can always just put that back. Okay. Get a little more of this blue. smaller angled brush. So I'm going to use this smaller angled brush just to get in all the little nooks and crannies around the pumpkins. Okay, I'm gonna go back in that bigger brush and just finish out right here. Now I'm going to just grab a little flat brush and tidy up a couple of spots right here. I got a little too much window. Just tidy that up. And then down here where I wiped off the black, it took some of the teal with it. And now we're going to go into our pumpkins. So I've got a few different oranges set out. I think I like, this one's called Bright Orange, and then this one's Pumpkin Spice or Spiced Pumpkin. Start off with our brighter orange. Okay. just going to fill everything in on our pumpkins. I might get a bigger brush than that. I have another one. See what I like the best. I think I'm gonna start off with that guy. I'm not really worried about painting over my lines as far as the drawn lines, but I do want to make sure that on the outside edges I don't go over. And I still do like to carry my strokes in the same direction that the item would go, so like I like the pumpkin to be roundy. I think for ease, I'm just painting right on over that stem. See that I have gotten a couple little orange plops. I go. Excuse me. Just making sure I got all the little orange pieces orange. Now I'm going to go with this spiced pumpkin. And I'm not going to put my hand right there. I don't want to try that. And I'm just going to like outline the edges of each little segment of the pumpkin just to give it some depth. Little shape. Just going around each little segment and putting this darker orange on it just to give it a little depth. Okay, I think we got all the little spaces. We're going to give that a minute to dry. And then we're going to start working on outlining parts. Good morning, Miss Jenny. How are you today? Sorry, I was waiting for the notification on Facebook. Yeah, I was a little late this morning, and then Facebook's notifications were even later, because I just got one a few minutes ago saying that I was live. But I've been here for a minute. My orange wanted to splatter. I guess I'll have to go back over that. I'm just going to put a touch of this gray. Thank you. Where I got a couple of little splatters of orange come down here. Just touch that up. Okay. I'm going to get out my black Posca pen, although it's already out, so it must be sitting right here on the table in front of me and I can't see for looking. I see my white one, but what have I done with my black one? It is right there in front of my face. So on here, there is, I'll show you the, on the tracer, there is this outline where like the tailgate would be on the truck. So we're going to outline that, and we're going to outline the bumper right now. And then I'm going to do this piece that goes right here. I think that one is for me. Just send it to my house. That's funny. still letting those pumpkins dry a little bit before I mess around too much in that area. I guess I could outline this side of the side mirror. Now those pumpkins are looking pretty dry. I think I'll at least do this part. Okay, we're going to do at least the outlines of the pumpkin part. We still got to go back in and do the stems. But I do want to get the outside of the pumpkin done. Okay, I think I am going to go ahead and do the stem color now, and then start working on stuff down here while it dries. This is just it's a raw umber. I thought it was milk chocolate, but it's not. It's raw umber. And I'm going to use a slightly smaller brush. Okay. Hit it with the heat gun for just a second. Give it a little jump start on getting dry. But we're going to go back over those again just to make them a little more solid. And then I want a little white right now. Tread on these tires. Just some highlights. Do a little decorative stuff. Over these stems one more time. Okay. While those are drying, I'm going to add some highlights to the pumpkins, too. Oh, some green leaves. I should add some green leaves. Let's see. That's too green. I need more of a fall green. Let me dig over here real quick. Some little darker green. I'll go with it. It is Hauser medium green. those Posca pens? Yes, they are Posca pens, and I absolutely love them. And some green leaves. Let's see what we can do about some green leaves. Go with a smaller brush because I don't want the leaves to be too big. I don't want them to overpower anything. One leaf up here. Touch of white. got some green leaves. I'm going to add a little vine twine thingy to attach them. So I add a little bit of water to my green just to make it a little soupier, make it run, flow a little easier. Maybe a little too much water. Actually, I should probably do my outline of my stems before I do that, so I'm going to hold off. We got practice ones in, but I'm going to do some real ones in a minute. I do want to add some highlights to the stems. So I'm just adding a little bit of white to that brown that I did the stem color. Now let's go back to our leaves. leaves dry, we're going to work on the welcome down at the bottom. I have it sketched out from the tracer, but it is a little hard to see. I can still put that over there without smearing that other paint. Welcome back in the same spot. Should be pretty close. That pencil's broken. Didn't look too bad at all. Alright, so we go back in with our Posca pen. Do you do markets in your part of town? How was the first day of school? It was stressful for me. We just recently moved here, and so I will be doing like a farmer's market type thing soon, but I haven't done any yet. I think it is November 5th. And then Jace's first day is making me nervous. We'll see how he feels about it when he gets home tonight. But as far as drop off, that went okay. He survived. I survived the biggest part. I just want to look at this welcome so I can fill it in as best I can. But I had been doing a lot of paint parties where we lived before. There's not as many locations nearby to do that now. So I think I will do some like local craft fair type things. Now, I think we need... I think we need some highlights on our leaves. Alrighty. And we could add just a few more details. Maybe like a little reflection, a little shine on that window and these two mirrors. And then of course I always like to add a little highlight to the lettering. I can't think of anything else to add to it. All right, guys, if you know anybody that would like something like this, that would want to paint along, go ahead and share it with them. Like, follow, all those good things. And we will see you next time. Bye, Miss Jenny. Thank you again for hanging out with us.